The final. Thank you. mano.
Shall I tell you about the Spira of days long past, eh? There is a legend, you know. Just before the horrible sin appeared, a terrible war raged between Bavel and Zanarkand. When the armies of Bavel attacked Mount Gagazet, they heard a song echoing across the snowy slopes. "'Tis a song from an other world," they said. Soldiers panicked and ran. Then, as if to pursue the retreating armies, sin appeared. Sometime later, scouts from the Bavel braved the mountain. On the other side, they witnessed the ruins that had been Zanarkand. A city destroyed, not a single soul left standing, gone. In its place, a multitude of the faith had gathered on Gagazet. They were singing a song. It's the song we now call the Hymn of the Faithful. And that, as they say, is that. Well, maybe not all of it. Would you like to hear the rest? Rumors flew in Bavel about sin's sudden appearance. They said that the people of Zanarkand became the faith that they had called sin, and that the man responsible was none other than the summoner Yevon, ruler of Zanarkand. Yes, the Lord Father of Lady Unaleska. On the eve of Zanarkand's destruction, Lady Unaleska had fled to safety with her husband, Zeon. Later, the two used the final summoning to defeat sin. Yet the people of Bavel still feared Yevon. It was to quell his wrath that they revered him and first spread his teachings. And so were born the temples of Yevon. I suppose it's possible Unaleska had planned it that way from the start. A fair trade. She defeats sin in exchange for her Lord Father's honor. Of course, there's no proof. No, the facts are lost in the mists of time. And who'd admit Yevon was an enemy of Bavel? You can bet the temples had a hand in covering that one up. And that, as they say, is that. Like to hear more, would you? Let me tell you about the Hymn of the Faith. It was once a Zanarkand song, sung in defiance of Bavel. Of course, the Yevon clergy and Bavel forbade it. Then, as these things often go, those who disliked Yevon began to sing it. The Albed, for instance. The Hymn of the Faith became the symbol of defiance against Yevon. Yevon could do nothing but capitulate. They lifted the ban on the song and spread a new story. They said the hymn was a song sung to soothe the souls of the dead. And so saying, they took the song and made it scripture. That's why today, the hymn is sung all over Spira. You could say that though Zanarkand is gone from this world, it lives on in the song. Ah, but look at the time. I've rambled on again. I do love stories, you see. Well, I owe you my gratitude for hearing this old scholar out. Like to him.
untouched by reality. Spiro will not forget its reality, nor the one who saved it. Run, dream, run on. Pass beyond the waking, and walk into the daylight.